Hey guys, this is John with Greenfish Nation. I want to welcome you to the channel today. Guys, today we're going to be reviewing the new lure, the Googans Squad Revolver. It's kind of like a whopper plopper. So you guys stay tuned for Greenfish Nation and our review of the Googans Squad Revolver. Actually a Googans Squad Revolver. Give you guys a close up of that. The propeller, so to speak, is in the middle on this revolver, and the hooks are at the back, so that tends to drive the fish toward the hooks versus the opposite, like on the whopper plopper. So you guys stay tuned here. We're going to give this revolver a try. I've never actually thrown one, but it sure looks like a good bait to me. All right, guys, here goes the revolver's first cast. Nice and heavy, cast real well. Sounds good. I like this bait because it's got a little fins on the back of it that keeps it from rolling over in the water. I think this was a real thought out bait by the Googans Squad. I'm reeling this on a Abu Garcia Black Max. It's a 6.4:1 gear ratio. Got it on a Abu Garcia Vengeance, medium heavy, 7'1" rod on some 12-pound trilene big game. I had a great time out at OH Ivy yesterday and the day before. We done some filming for a real good fella out there, Brandon Burks. I got to meet his dad, Donald. Super, super good people. If you guys are in the market to possibly catch a fish of a lifetime, boy right there can get it done for you. Went out there, like I said yesterday, we had a 10, an 8, 7, 5, and several 4s. Man, it was something else. You guys also check out his channel. I'm kind of working on his channel with him. It's called Burks Fishing. It's on YouTube here, and he's on TikTok and all kind of stuff, Facebook. He's the one that's always posting the giants on Facebook, so y'all check him out. All right, guys, all this area that you see here, it was all bone dry for several months. It had some grass growed up in it, so we're gonna give this revolver a try over here. Well, there was one. Give this fella a try over here again. All right, there we go. There's one right there, guys. Guys, look at the hook setup on that. Make sure I ain't standing in fire ants. He got one in the mouth there. He got the front hook. And he got the back hook right behind his gill plate. He's got good sharp hooks on it. Fish number one on the revolver. I bet there's another one in there. Guys, I'm gonna swing y'all around to this other side. It also has a lot of grass in it. I'm trying to fish where you guys are out of the sun, but right over here in this area, right out here, there's an old laydown. It's usually pretty good to fish around. Well, there's one little offer. Right up here close in the grass. Kind of makes you wonder how long he was following it, don't it? Well, he got it that time. He's a little more dedicated to it that time. He said, let me go on and get that before it comes by here again. Well, there's number two on the revolver, guys. Stay tuned for more. Tried to get Stephanie to fish with this a while ago, but she wanted to stick with a worm. She caught her two or three right there real quick, and then she's sitting in the car. Said her hands were hurting. This getting old business has been tough on me and her both. Guess I'm gonna keep going till I can't throw a rod and reel no more. There's another one on the old revolver. Right over that little lay down like I was talking about. Number three on the revolver. He's little, but he's committed. I think you just gotta find the right speed. It'll make that right sound that they want. Another thing I like about this lure is a lot of times on that whopper plopper, when you throw it, your hooks will get tangled up around your line. These hooks are a little further back. And they don't seem to do that. Or at least they haven't yet. Make another cast. There's one offer. Get an offer like that, I'm gonna go right back to him. Let him have another chance at it. And he's hit at it twice now, three times. Must be a little cuss. Or a big brim or a crappie. Sounds like a mud boat coming across there. Well, we're going to try to go after and get him again. All right, guys, we've moved down the pond here to a big grass flat. It's got deep water on both sides. We're going to continue with this revolver. We've got three fish caught on it, and we've had about five or six hits at it that missed it. So let's see what we can do on this revolver on this grass flat. Guys, that one was a quick release. He hit it, got him up on the bank, unhooked, and he went west. So we'll try another. That was fish number four on the old revolver. He hit it literally 3 foot from the bank. Cast into the wind, just as good as it does with the wind. Water's got a little bit of a green hue to it. gonna bring it right here in front of us. Well guys, I think that's just gonna do it for this revolver. Review by Googans Squad. I don't have anything bad to say about this lure. I like the action of it. I like the sound of it. I like that the propellers in front of the rear hooks. Got a little better close-up of it there. It's got this, if you look at it from the back, it's got a fin on each side there that keeps that thing from twisting. I like that. Here's the propeller. It's a single blade. It's got a good smooth rotation to it. I don't see any problems with that. I didn't have any issues with it getting caught up in grass and getting wrapped up around the prop there. The way it's built, it's kind of inset on the front into the head. Like I said, it's got good hooks and it's got good split rings. Well, guys, I'd give it a try. Until next time, I'm John with Greenfish Nation. Thanks for joining us today. If you haven't subscribed, guys, click that subscribe button. We'd appreciate it. Thank you again. Until next time, tight lines.